In this short video, under 10 minutes, I'm going to walk you through how to get started with your online classes this semester. And the first place to go to get started with your classes is iConnect. iConnect is located at iConnect.mwcc.edu, and you just use your username and password to log into this student portal. By student portal, what I mean is that everything in this section of Mount Wachusett's online presence is designed just for you. There is no ads in iConnect, and you can safely click on anything and explore. So I definitely recommend you do that. One of the first things I recommend that you explore is this option over here to download Office 365. That gives you the ability to download for free the entire Microsoft Office suite, which includes Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And so you're going to want to make sure you have those programs before your classes get started. The other main thing you're going to see here is your student email. Student email is really important because it is the number one way that faculty and staff get a hold of you. You're going to want to get in the habit of checking your email regularly. And what you'll notice here is that students have their email powered by Google. Next to that, my iConnect looks a little different than yours because I am staff at the college, and you'll see that the employee email has a different logo. That is important to remember because it means that if you share something from your student Google Drive to a faculty or staff member, they can't open it. We do not have Google accounts. And so if you choose to use Google Drive to complete your assignments, you're going to need to download those assignments and send them as attachments to faculty and staff on campus. It's important to keep that into consideration because we won't have a way to see what you're doing if you just send a link through your drive. The other thing here in iConnect, which is what our focus is today, is Blackboard. And so I'm going to click on that. And while it loads, I just want to explain a few things about Blackboard to you. The first is that you should really be accessing Blackboard through a computer or a tablet. There is a phone app for Blackboard, but it does not show you everything that's embedded in your classes. And so if you only use a phone to look at your classes, you're going to be missing out on a lot of information. The next thing is that Blackboard itself can be customized by each professor. So each of your classes is going to look a little different. But like iConnect, you can safely click around in each class to get used to it. And we have staff available to help you explore your classes as well. So I clicked on the Blackboard app and it takes me to this big busy page, but what's most important to me is what's in the center that says My Courses. And you can see a whole bunch of stuff here. All of this stuff is populated when classes begin. So the first day of classes is when your links to your online classes are going to show up. And I'm going to click on one right now. It's a class I'm currently teaching, and show you the way around my Blackboard page. The reason I tell you I'm showing you the way around my Blackboard page is because, again, they can all look a little different. And so this is the basic layout, but colors and links and information is going to change from class to class. On this page, you see the first thing that happens when you click into it is that we get to the announcements section. The announcements section shows anything I post to students. And it shows it in date order. So it's kind of like a live message board that you can scroll through. You're gonna see my assignments for the week. You're gonna see extra credit opportunities. You're gonna see check-in videos. You're gonna see links to outside resources, all of that kind of stuff. And that is exactly why it's really important that you access this page through a computer or tablet, because wherever you see these links or embedded videos or embedded images, those might not show up on your phone, and so the announcement isn't quite going to make sense to you. I also have my Blackboard page organized so that all of these announcements get sent to your student email account as well. But again, you want to click in to read them here to make sure you're seeing everything that's included. The left-hand side, this green section for me, is that area of the page that can get really customizable. So again, I'm showing you what is in the class that I am teaching, but you're going to want to look through this and see how it's organized in each class. For mine, we've got the textbook and syllabus section, and here you're going to see a link to my textbook because I use a free online one, and a link to my syllabus. Every single one of your classes is going to have a syllabi, and this is where you get the bulk of the information about how the class operates. Okay, so you have contact info right at the top, the description of the course. You have information on how to email me in our attendance, how I'm going to grade you in the class, what our grading point system looks like, as well as due dates for every single assignment for the entire semester. So make sure you spend a fair amount of time reading through your syllabi for each class within the first week of school so that you can stay on top of what is due. Underneath that textbook and syllabus section is faculty info. It's another place where you can read information about me. If your teachers have Zoom drop-in hours or the ability to have appointments with you, they might put it in here in addition to your syllabi. So this is a good place to look as well. And then you see I've got my page organized so that the current week assignments are right at the top, and then everything that's past due is populated below it. A lot of teachers organize this differently, but one thing that we all utilize for the most part is the discussion board. Discussion board is a place where you not only talk to me in the class, but you talk to your fellow students as well. And you can see in my class, there's a discussion board assignment pretty much every week. There's videos for students to watch and questions for them to answer. And when you click into any one of these, you can do so by just clicking on the title of it. You can see who else has posted here, and then you can respond by clicking Create Thread. That is one of the biggest, most frequent questions that faculty and staff get asked the first week of class. So I'm going to do it again. Students ask, how do I respond in the discussion board? Click into the discussion board. Click on the title of the discussion board that you wish to respond to, and then click on Create Thread. In here, you can respond to the discussion board questions. So you can put a subject, you can put your text response answer, and then when you can upload something if you want, and then when you're done, you just hit submit. And that's how you respond to a discussion board. I'm not going to submit anything because this class is live right now. Okay. The other area of your class that most of your teachers are going to have is course content. Course content is where you can see worksheets for the class, where you can see lessons, you can see assignments, you can see any kind of thing that your teacher wants to bundle together as the bulk of the work of the class. And this works similar to the announcement page where everything piles up in date order and you go through it as the class is moving forward. Okay. Underneath that course content section, at least on my page, is an area where you can check your grades. I recommend that you check your grades at least once every week or two. One, to make sure that your assignment's actually uploaded correctly, and two, so you can always be aware of your status in the class, how you're doing, and where you stand. So always check this out, and you can sort it in lots of different ways. Mine doesn't have a lot going on because obviously I don't have any grades in the class that I'm teaching. But you can look at it as a whole. You can see just what's been graded. You can see what's still left to be graded, and you can double check on anything that you've submitted to see if you've got feedback on it and that it make sure it's been uploaded correctly. You can use the email section of the site to email your teacher directly. You can also use it to email other students in the class. There's a tutoring section that'll connect you to our tutoring partner, ThinkingStorm. You're welcome to use that, or you can use MWCC tutors as well. Just search the word tutoring at Mount Wachusett's main website, mwcc.edu, and you'll get to the tutoring page. You'll also note here, most of our classes have live a 24/7 help desk link. And so if you have questions or you need help in your classes, you can connect on that. And you can click on that and you can connect with staff that can assist you with using iConnect as well as with basic Blackboard questions. So, that is the overview of your Blackboard classes. And again, I want to reiterate, they'll each look a little different, but it is perfectly fine for you to click around all of them. You can't mess it up. If you do, we will help you fix it. And please take some time the first week of class to do that. If you would like to go through your Blackboard pages with a staff member, you can email the tutoring center. I'll put that email address right here. And we will organize a staff member to come and meet you on Zoom and walk through them with you if you need it. So stay in touch if you have questions. You are not in this alone, and I hope this video is helpful in you getting settled.